Dach and another official who debriefed Bergdahl both testified that his time in Germany was extended partly so he could offer additional time-sensitive intelligence. Terence Russell, a division chief for the Joint Personnel Recovery Agency, developed a 1,200-page transcript from debriefing Bergdahl that was turned into a database. The information produced reports on tactics used by insurgents and hostage takers in the region that are still used by the military. Russell said he'd like to learn even more from Bergdahl, but the soldier's legal case has impeded that. Can you give him to me tomorrow? I need him. I need him now, he said to a defense attorney. The fact that I can't get that information is wrong. I need that. We don't have very many examples coming out of Afghanistan, he said. Russell, who's debriefed more than 100 former hostages and prisoners of war, said Bergdahl's time in the cage was damaging psychologically because he was kept in isolation nearly the entire time. They simply shut the door. Long-term isolation. Psychological abuse, he said. It was extreme neglect. They just let him nearly rot inside that cage for 4 years. The defense showed the court images of a replica of the cage that Russell's agency built, using Bergdahl's sketches. Russell uses it for survival training. Bergdahl's sentencing hearing is expected to last several more days. Follow Drew at